Hey everyone, welcome to the Hornet King channel, and in this video, I'll be removing a European hornet colony that decided to make its nest inside of a tree trunk. This nest was just packed with larvae and pupating adults, so I brought the nest home and tweezed off a bunch of the larvae and the pupating adults and fed them to my emus, my Rhea, my chickens, and my squirrel. Here's the video, check it out. I'm the Hornet King, and I removed some incredible and insane wasp nests. Okay, so we got European hornets in this tree that the client would like me to cut out. So I'm going to cut it out for him. I'm gonna do an exploratory cut at first, just see roughly where the nest is. I already poked a hole in the envelope and they did not like that at all. They came pouring out, but I hid behind the tree like a sissy. So I'm gonna vacuum up a bunch for right now. That'll give me a better idea as to what to expect inside. Just gonna vacuum up some of the foragers for right now. Before I make any cuts.
Look at all these hive beetles.
Smell like stink bugs. Yeah, this is a mess.
Bagged up and fed to the animals.
Good as new.
Alright, so I'm going to tweeze out some of these European hornet larvae. Mainly just so I can give them to the birdies. I mean, they could probably peck a lot of these out, but if I just toss these out, the emus are going to hog them up. I'm not going to get much for the actual birdies, the chickens. So I'll just take my time and tweeze up some of these. Of course, I'm looking through the screen, which makes this harder. Start looking. There we go. These are in the refrigerator, so they're just a little bit cool. They're not dead. They're just slowed way down. And this obviously is just soft comb. Not much to it. So these, I'll take the silk caps off. I'm gonna put this on, lock the screen. There we go. So I'll expose a bunch of these pupating adults under here. You don't want to dig too much because then you rip the heads off them like I just did there. You kind of just want to just pull right at the tippy top of the silk cap. But it's easier said than done. And then what you're left with is a bunch of pupators in my hand. And there you go. Gotta be gentle when you put them in the bucket. So usually what I do is I just stand out in front of the birdies and just do this, pick them out, pick the silk caps off. But then you got Sweetie, Baby, and Rhea-the-Rhea trying to peck at the comb while I'm doing it, which makes it more of a pain in the butt. So I prefer to just do it right here. That way nobody bothers me, even though this is inside where... making a mess in my office. So now we just dump everywhere.
these pupators pop really, really easily. So you got to be really gentle. You can be pretty tough with the larva, but pupating adults, you got to be really, really careful because they'll pop and they juice all over the place. That's mainly just pupating adults at this point, but some larva. Now, the chickens will not do this. The emus will just pretty much just tear into the comb, break it apart, but they won't rip the silk caps off very well by themselves. They'll grab the whole comb and like flip it over their heads and stuff. But so to really get the larva out without just destroying the comb, and basically what the emus will grab the comb and try to get the silk caps off, smush it, and then all the comb gets saturated with the guts of the pupating adults and the larva, and then they kind of eat some of it, but they don't eat all of it. So the best way to ensure that the whole nest is being eaten properly, like all the adults and stuff are being eaten, that all the pupating adults are being eaten and stuff, is to actually come in here and rip them off by hand and get them out. Otherwise, it's just a waste. European Hornet comb is so brittle. It just like falls apart in your hands. That one's head off. As you can imagine, this takes a bit of time. It can be a little bit frustrating because you have to be gentle, you gotta be delicate, but you also have to tear them off pretty hard at the same time. All right, so I wanna weigh this comb out so you guys can see how heavy the larva are. So we're at 0 pounds. So we're at 9.8 ounces in that comb. So I'm going to tweeze everything off, get all the pupating adults out of it, and then we'll weigh it, and then we'll subtract that out. A lot more further developed adults in this one. some of these out. Keep on rolling. Can I help you? All right. So let's weigh this cone. It's 9.9 ounces. Let's see what this cone weighs now. 1 ounce, 1.2 ounce. So that's 8.7 ounces of larva that was in there. That's crazy. So let's take this out and give this to the birdies. You're going to, buddy.
Hello, birdies.
You ready for some yummy larva, birdies? Rhea-the-Rhea. The good birdies?
Oh, Rhea-the-Rhea. Hello, birdie. Nice big birdie.
I got something for you, Squirrel. Come down here and eat it, Squirrel. Oh, what a good Squirrel. What a good Squirrel. Did you make that mess, Squirrel? Come here and nibble it, Squirrel. Nibble this nest, Squirrel. What a good Squirrel. Oh, what a good Squirrel. Are you a good Squirrel? Are you a happy Squirrel? Are you a larva eating Squirrel? I love your tail, Squirrel. What a nice Squirrel tail, Squirrel. Eat lots of larvae, Squirrel. Oh, is that a juicy one? Oh, what a good Squirrel. Oh, what a good Squirrel. Don't be so spazzy, Squirrel. Come on, Squirrel. Come on, Squirrel. It's just my suit, Squirrel. That's what makes noise the way it does.
Alright everyone, thank you so much for tuning in to check out this video. If you guys enjoyed this content, drop in the comments, let me know what you think. If you have any suggestions for future videos or something you'd like to see me cover in an upcoming video, also drop in the comments and let me know. If you guys haven't subscribed already, please consider doing so and hit the bell notification down below, and that way you guys get an update anytime I do post a video. Thank you so much for tuning in to check out this video and supporting my channel, and I'll catch you on the next video.